Hello again, YouTube. Today I want to show you three great alternatives to MidJourney that are better than MidJourney in a lot of ways. And not only are these tools amazing, but they're completely free right now and require no installation. That's right, you heard me. Completely free and no installation required. Let's be honest, MidJourney is the cream of the crop when it comes to visual fidelity and ease of use. But these three tools have advanced features that give them a slight edge over MidJourney, or at least to compete with it. All of these tools can produce similar results to MidJourney, but it takes a bit of practice and you need some prompting skills, but it's doable. And I'm gonna go over each tool, the pros, the cons, how to get started. This isn't an in-depth guide on these tools, and I have separate videos for that in the description. But after this video, you might wanna make the switch from MidJourney to one of these free tools. So the first tool is Leonardo.ai. And this tool takes a little bit of effort to try and get into because you have to request over here by email to count me in, and then it sends you an email, then you have to go to their Discord, then the Discord gives you a form, and then you go back and then you sign in with your email, you get whitelisted, and then you could launch the app over here. But once you're done, you could just click on yes, I'm whitelisted, and you could get in like a normal tool. So one of the first cool things about this site is the community page. So there's a lot of cool models here, and if you go through it, you can see that the quality of these models are just like MidJourney. Look at this. This is one of those paper, I don't know what they're called, paper cut style, and it looks just like you would see in MidJourney. So I mean, they're beautiful. And you look at all the other pictures in here, you can see that this thing could prompt some really nice stuff. And just keep in mind, these prompts are pretty long. They're not like MidJourney where you can put in like 5 words and you get something nice. If you look at some of these prompts, they're like a mile long. Check it out. So you got to put a few things in here to get it to look this nice, but you can create some really nice artwork in here. Whoa. Okay. All right. So I got to mention that while you're going through this site, sometimes you'll see some boobies in here. You can also turn off an NSFW switch in your personal feed to not see that stuff, or vice versa. And if you take a look here, you have your own personal feed. So you have your own pictures in here, and my pictures are disgusting, but you have your like pictures, which is even better. So you can see all the art just like in MidJourney. You can click on the pictures that you like and keep it in here so you can reference them for when you want to create art. You can see the kind of prompts they use, and you could even remix them. You can go in here, you could click on remix and mess with it. You can do image to image. You could even copy the prompt. So just that alone is already a very big plus. And also the pictures in here are really nice. So I mean, look at the quality of these, and pretty nice, all of them. Now the next really cool feature is that you can train your own data set. So if you wanted a specific look, or you wanted to consistent output of a certain person, or to put them, make them a superhero or something like that, you can actually train your own data set, and it's pretty quick. So you can just put in a couple pictures and just throw them in here. And then when it's done, you'll have your own little code that you could put into your prompts to get that style or that person or whatever you trained. You can see more of that. The next pro is its AI canvas. And if you ever been on Runway ML, this is called the infinite canvas. And you can put in a picture here, then you could keep expanding on it, building on it, and you can create outside the borders until this picture becomes insanely huge. And so you can just keep moving a picture to the right, moving it to the left, and just keep making that picture bigger and adding things to it. So that's a pretty cool feature that MidJourney definitely doesn't have, and a lot of other apps don't have it as well. And perhaps its coolest feature would be the fine-tuned models. So when you go in here, you can actually search through the community models that have been trained by them, and you can use these to create a certain look or a certain type of picture. So if you want to create some 3D apples, there you go. You can use this model to make it easier for you. And here's a Lego one. And there's just so many creations here, which makes it so easy to make stuff. Someone even made one of Andrew Tate, really. So, I mean, just check it out. You have nothing to lose. It's completely free right now while it's in alpha. And then you have about 250 tokens per day. And that's pretty much unlimited until they start charging a subscription fee, which I don't know when that is. One important thing to point out about Leonardo.ai is that you get 250 tokens per day. And so that's not 250 pictures, because a picture, if you put the quality all the way up, can cost you anywhere from 5 to 10 tokens. But that's also considering that you're probably making like 2 or 3 generations. But yeah, the community models feature is a very, very nice feature. And they also have some platform models that I guess they're created by the actual developers, and these are pretty insane. So there's a lot of video game stuff, and even on the front of the website, it seems like they're really focusing on video game development as the theme. So here's a look at the website here, and they're showing icons and little game assets that you can make here. So that's pretty neat as well. I'd like to see what they do in the future. See if they actually create something which is AI art to 3D generation, which is possible. That'd be really cool to see it on the site. Next up is Blue Willow. And this is, out of all the three, this is the easiest one to get into, but it doesn't have any advantages over MidJourney. But what it does have an advantage of over the other two is that you can use this in Discord. So you could bring it mobile. You can do anything you can do with MidJourney in Discord. Well, kind of. I have a full video on that. It's in the description. So if you want to learn more about that, you can check it out. But it's as easy as clicking on join the free beta to get in. Now, looking at it, the pictures it produces are not very consistent, which, so they're in early stages of development. And so the pictures aren't as nice, but every now and then they produce some really nice results. And they got some really weird style putting these pictures together. So it seems like they take a combination of all the pictures they think you would like and then just kind of mesh them together for you and then give you your prompt, which is weird. It's very different from what Diffusion is, and it works similarly, but it's, the concept sounds the same, but it's not. Diffusion works by gradually replacing visual noise. So it looks at your prompt and it sees what you want, and then it compares it to the weights that it has, and then it tries to create something similar to what you're asking for. Blue Willow aggregates multiple models, and they describe themselves as like the Google flights for AI models, which I'm not sure if that's a good idea or if it's a great idea. So I'm just, we'll see what it can do in the future. But right now it's having a little bit trouble getting off its feet. The pictures are very inconsistent, but sometimes you get something really unique and really nice. So again, the pictures here are not as great as the other two, but it's works just like MidJourney. You go into Discord and then you message the bot, and then you could type whatever you want in here. So similar to MidJourney, you would type /imagine, and then you would put something in the prompt, like maybe a tree by H. Geiger. And then you just wait for it to generate. Same as MidJourney. I will say it seems to do really good with words, which is something that MidJourney can't do. So I guess that's one thing it has over MidJourney. Look at this. It's spelled coffee every single time. That's different. Usually I'll say like copy or coffee or something weird, because I don't know why AR doesn't seem to want to work with words. I found a solution for that, but that's for another video. Another advantage that Blue Willow has over the other two is that it has unlimited generation. So, I mean, if you generate a lot, they'll put you in a queue, but you have a limited generation. And also, it seems like the one that's earliest in development, so it's probably going to be out here for free for a very long time. I'd say 6 months to a year, you'll be able to play with this tool for free on Discord. And that means that you could put it on your tablet, put it on your phone, and you could take it mobile. Anything that has the Discord app, you can use this.
By the way, if you like the video and found a new awesome AI art tool, go ahead and give the video a thumbs up. If you like all things AI and want to learn more about artificial intelligence, click the subscribe button. You probably didn't notice that I was using text-to-speech with a cloned voice to do the last three sentences. I'll leave a video on how to do that in the description. Beep, boop, beep. Let's continue, shall we?
Last but not least, and definitely my favorite, the one that creates the most beautiful art and has the best tools, is playgroundAI. Check out some of the artwork this creates. I'm not sure if this one's NSFW or not, but she has no nipples, so it's just kind of like she's wearing a bra.
He says she ain't had no nipples!
Check it out. I mean, the artwork it produces here is pretty amazing. The only downside is people can do things to hide the prompt and just kind of mess it up. So you think that's the prompt, but that's not the prompt. But check this site out, man. It creates some beautiful stuff. Look at this one. I really like this picture. And what's cool too is that it has a lot of options. So out of all the tools, this one has the most options. I know you looked at LeonardoAI and you were like, that thing has a lot of tools. Well, this one has more. So if you go to this picture, you can do a bunch of things to it. So if it was your own picture, you can actually make it private. I'll show you that in a second. But right now you can actually click edit and you have a lot of options here. So you can actually click on her, add a mask, go like that, and then add a mustache. And look how expertly it did that. I mean, it's weird, but you know, a little kid with a mustache and a cyber, I don't know. That is a pretty powerful tool. You can do a lot of things with this. And let me show you another thing real quick, just since we're just playing with it. I just painted a little mask on her face and I put Avatar Navi photorealistic, and look what it did. It's pretty amazing. Now let me change the color of her hair. Let's make it blonde. So you can just trash that. Just go on with the mask, color over her hair real quick. And this will turn you into a Photoshop pro overnight. It'll take seconds. Something that would take somebody hours will take you seconds. Let me put numb blonde, wavy hair. And check this out. And just like that, it changed the color of the hair and it looks amazing. Looks real and looks pretty good. Very nice. Very nice.
Very nice. How much?
So another pro is just like Leonardo AI, you can see all the things that you like. You can see all the images that you created as well as the community page. So here are some of the images that I liked, and you can see there's a theme here. But yeah, it's pretty amazing. And then now we can look at my images. So these are some of the things that I created. And one that's pretty interesting is this girl right here. So I turned this girl into this girl into this girl, and I did it in 25 seconds using that Pix2Pix tool that they have, and it's pretty powerful. It's pretty amazing. It's in the video description if you want to check it out. It's a very short video. I actually used this girl too to turn it into this girl. So I just changed the color of her hair and also gave her some pants. But that tool is pretty amazing. The next thing to take note is you can actually open up a picture, then click on this ellipsis button, and then you could either upscale it 4 times or make this photo private. So if you didn't want anyone to see this, you can just click on make private and that's it. It'll image privacy updated and that's it. You can download it. And also the cool thing is you can remix it and go to edit, and edit has a lot of cool features. So you can go to the Pix2Pix and change things about her features like I showed you earlier, or you can actually do a remix, and you can also do image to image. Cool thing about image to image is you can either import that photo here. So I can import this photo and start drawing on it and do an image to image, or I can do a doodle. I know this is a video about free alternatives, but let's check out the pricing on this one. So this is the model that actually has some pricing plans. And if you go into the pro, it's just a little bit better and you get some more freedoms, and you also can create 2000 images per day, and you can do no limits on the image dimensions up to 1 megapixel. And then you could also add Dolly 2 for $10 more. Something to note is that you don't get Dolly 2 by default if you get the pro version. You actually have to get the 2 plans, so the 15 and the 10. So it's going to be 25 a month if you want Dolly in the pro plan. But the free plan is very generous and you can do 1,000 images per day. That's a lot of images. Also, you can do up to 50 steps, which is pretty high for me. I don't really create things over 50 steps anyways. And then you also have a lot of the other tools like the Pix2Pix. You got the filters. It's a pretty generous free plan. And the best thing about it is that you can use these images commercially, so you can sell them. The only downside is that it uses Stable Diffusion 1.5 and 2.1 mostly. So it's not very easy to create these pictures. You need quite a bit to put these in here. And people actually hide the prompts usually. See, it says here will not produce the same result when remixed. So this guy went in here and he removed all this and threw the picture back in here with a fake prompt. So good luck on trying to recreate this picture. I have ways though, but you know, it's not as easy as remixing through here, like on Leonardo AI. Another thing to mention is with 2.1 came the issue with negative prompts. So you need to put a bunch of negative prompts so you don't get a really ugly picture. And that's something to keep in mind if you're doing anything with version 2.1. You need a lot of negative prompts like ugly, blurry, deformed hands, and all that stuff needs to be in there. You need like a paragraph long of negative prompts in here. But those are the only two cons for this tool. Other than that, it's pretty amazing and it's definitely my favorite out of the three. But it really depends on what you're trying to do with the tool. So I mean, if you want to do some training, you want to get consistent imagery, then you're going to have to go to Leonardo. And just like Leonardo AI, you can actually select different types of filters and create a specific style that you want here based on what they have available to you. So you can create pixel art just by selecting this, and then you could just type something in here like, I'm going to put in elf princess and see what it gives us. I'm going to put in elf princess Greg Rutowski. And if you didn't know, Greg Rutowski is like the cheat code to make anything look pretty good. But you know, it's pixel art, so it's going to be pixelated. But this is what I got. And all I had to do was choose that filter. Let's try another filter. I know they have the paper one, which is pretty neat. Oh, let's try this masterpiece one here. And I'll put... All right, I put something in there. So let's check out what it does with the masterpiece filter and see what it creates. That is a masterpiece. Well, it's a little low detail, but we can fix that. But you can already see that it has all these fine lines, details, and the armor is very intricate. So that's what that does. Finally, I want to give a quick shout out to Stable Diffusion because this really is the best tool. So, I mean, you can go into extensions and you could add so much more functionality in this tool. You can add instruct Pix2Pix, which is when you put a mustache on a girl. You can do dream booth. You could train. You can do deforum, which is text to video. I did a video on that as well. You can do text to image, and in here they have control net now. So you can actually add this as well, which is the next level thing for AI art. I think that this really solves a lot of problems that AI art had, and it really gives a lot more functionality. And this is a must have, this control net. If you don't know what it is, you need to watch a video on it, and I'll have a video up soon and I'll put that in the description as soon as it's available. But this is a pretty powerful tool or set of tools. So just a quick pro and cons breakdown. So the first one is Blue Willow. So the pros on that is it has a Discord style prompting. It's very familiar if you use MidJourney, and you could use it on your mobile phone, your tablet. You can bring it anywhere. Right now it has infinite usage. You can make as many pictures as you want. The cons is it doesn't really have a community forum aside from the individual Discord channels, which isn't really a gallery, and it's a pain in the butt to look at. Next is Playground AI. And so let's look at the pros and the cons. So this is my favorite tool by far. It has a community feed, you have your own personal feed, you can remix pictures, and you have a 1,000 daily limit. So you can create 1,000 pictures a day. That's not 1,000 tokens, that's 1,000 pictures. It has inpainting, it has image to image, it has that doodling image to image where you can draw a stick figure and have that get turned into something. It has Pix2Pix, which is where you can put a mustache on a girl or Photoshop, you know, their hair a different color. So that's a very strong tool. And it has all the filters, so you can choose a specific filter to make generating art a lot easier to do. And the coolest thing about this site is the pictures it generates. So the pictures here are simply beautiful, and just take a look at it when you have a chance. And it's also very easy to get signed up. You just click on sign in with my Google account and you're good to go. So the last one on my list, but the first one I went over, is Leonardo.ai. And I think that a lot of people will enjoy this one more than the other ones that I mentioned. It's not my personal favorite, but I think that in general, this has the most functionality for other people. And it does have the community feed and your personal feed, which is amazing. It has the ability to train without doing all the complicated stuff in Stable Diffusion, which is pretty amazing. That's next level. And it also has the fine-tuned models that are generated by the community, as well as the ones that are generated by the developers here, and those make creating art a lot easier. So you have more control to create very beautiful images here by using these models and these fine-tuned models. And it also has the AI canvas, and they're coming out with a lot more stuff. I mean, they're always coming out with new stuff. And they even have something that's coming out, which is like a prompt generator where you put in like something like a robot or something, it'll give you a bunch of suggestions on what you can create with that. So it's like GPT-4 or something. I don't know what they're using, but it's AI that gives you suggestions on what you can create off a single word. So that's pretty amazing. And the pictures here are stunning. So, I mean, look at this one right here. I mean, the wrinkles, it's a pretty amazing picture. You can see a lot of nude girls here, though, so just careful when you're scrolling through it. You don't want to be doing that at work, but this one is a pretty amazing site. Overall, I think this is the one that more people would like, and I like Playground AI because of the things I like to do in my art. I like the Pix2Pix. I would hope that this site actually has that one day. But if I want to do some training, I want to look at some fine-tuned models, this one has the biggest database of fine-tuned models because of the training and because of the community models. That's a huge thing here is these community models. I mean, it's infinite. There's a lot of people creating stuff here, and there's endless models here that you could choose from. And really, that's how you beat the competition. You give the community the ability to kind of work for you and create all sorts of stuff that people can choose from. Look at the models it has here. So there's even one that kind of tickles my fancy, Fantasy Races. I like that one. I should try that out. But yeah, look at how many there are. It's just endless. And that's because they make it so easy to train. And this is pretty cool. I don't know, maybe Leonardo's my favorite now. I haven't played with this one so much, but definitely it's a toss-up between Leonardo and Playground AI. But if I was on the go, I wanted to do it mobile, I would go to Blue Willow. But, you know, so we have a lot of options here for things that are even better. What is this? What is that? For tools that can make pictures that are just like MidJourney and also have more functionality with the training, the fine-tuned models, the Pix2Pix, the AI canvas, the infinite canvas generation, and all the different stuff that they have on these sites. I mean, I would use all three of them, but it's up to you. Choose the one you want. It's free. That's all I had for now. And if you liked the video, or if you found a new tool watching this video, go ahead and give the video a thumbs up. Thanks for watching, and take it easy.